Hello, I'm Patrick McGee, sports writer with Sun Herald.
I'm Patrick Oaks. This is Sports Guys Week 5.
We're going to talk about Friday night's big games. I'll be talking about Stanislaus at D'Iberville and also St. Martin at East Central.
And I'll kick things off talking about Picayune, our new number one, traveling to Harrison Central. Interesting matchup. I've covered Picayune the last 2 weeks. Come away impressed both times. 2 weeks ago, they really held down a potentially dangerous St. Martin offense. You know, now a couple weeks into the season, we haven't quite seen that from them. But then, you know, Gulfport seemed to be a pretty well-rounded team as well, and they really smothered that offense, didn't allow them to get out. It's interesting, Picayune offensively, against St. Martin, they had a couple 70, 80-yard touchdown runs. Against Gulfport, it was more incremental. They just kind of moved down the field methodically, were able to punch it in and capitalize at a couple good points. Then you look at Harrison Central, they come out of the gate 2-0, lose a tough one up in Pearl River County last week at PRC. The interesting stat to me, we were talking about this a little bit ago, Keon Moore, who's been one of the better running backs on the coast, you've come away impressed when you've seen him. They held him in check in a way. He rushed 9 times for 34 yards, but he still had 2 touchdowns. Tavis Williams was kind of the big ball carrier last week for them. I think if Harrison Central is going to have success, they need to have Keon Moore kind of break out, break free for some big runs. Unfortunately for Harrison Central, Picayune has their linebacking core and really their front line, I think, do a really good job of containing opposing running backs. I don't think they're going to break out again. I think Harrison Central is going to end up being 2-2 after this week. I think Picayune continues to cruise in offense and wins maybe by 14 points. Then you have Hancock traveling to Poplarville. It's an interesting one. We both know De La Salle is a good team, but they've stuck it to a couple of the coast teams here the last couple weeks. Hancock was one of those teams that came away with a lopsided loss. Then you have Poplarville. We're able to hang on. I think they scored the last 10 points last week to pull out a big win. Poplarville has Bolton and Purnell, two dangerous running backs. They can really make defenses spread out a little bit, kind of worry about both of them. Their quarterback's mobile too. And they've just kind of continued to find ways to win this season. You look at Hancock, Stephen Good, who was at Bayhigh previously, has been a really nice addition for them. He is not only is he a pretty accurate passer for him, but he's also a threat in the run game, which has helped them in the first couple weeks before they played De La Salle. With Poplarville, though, I think they're still riding high. And as long as Bolton and Purnell are healthy, you know, I think they've got a chance in pretty much every game moving forward. I think they win by 10.
Yeah, I think Poplarville wins that game. St. Martin going to East Central. St. Martin's hit a little bit of a rough patch. Not so surprising that they lost to Picayune, especially knowing what we know now. But losing to Crestview, a team that they handled on the road pretty well last year, that was surprising. So St. Martin trying to figure things out right now, and they're playing an East Central team, which is really rolling. They beat East Central pretty good last year at St. Martin. But as we saw, in the Picayune game, St. Martin's had some issues with the wing tee. And stuff like that. So I think it's maybe part of it's another kind of a bad matchup for St. Martin going on the road to East Central. One of the best rushing offenses in the state. Tony Brown's about to already hit 1,000 yards.
Yeah, he's doing okay.
We're in week number 5, and he's been pretty busy, so he's going to hit 1,000 yards this week. And it's just not him. They have a good offensive line. They have a good backup running back as well, a bunch of different options. So I see East Central winning that game. Maybe by a touchdown. I see it being kind of a barn burner. The East Central comes out on the end. And, of course, Stanislaus D'Iberville, that's really the big talker this week. Yeah. Miles Brennan, Stanislaus quarterback, enters that game 125 yards shy of the state record. He'll eclipse Dylan Favre, former Rockachaw, as the state's top passer, and that should happen, you would think, sometime in the first half, unless D'Iberville really comes out and plays good defense, which they have done.
Which
they've played really good defense. I think D'Iberville is one of those teams that's really exceeded all expectations. I think there was some thought that this was going to be a rough year for D'Iberville in Eric Collins' first year there, but he's really got things going. They went to Oak Grove and won. That was really impressive. And they shut out Pascagoula, which, Pascagoula was in a tight spot at the point, not playing that well. But, Pascagoula is still Pascagoula. So
they have that potential.
Yeah, and that defense features a really good safety, and Tyler Barnes may cause some problems. We don't know. I think it's a good game. But, Stanislaus is going to be so amped up for this one. They've played a couple of lackluster games the last couple of times out. Bill Conady's admitted as such whenever I talked to him today. I see them really hitting the field ready to go. against the Iowerville, I see probably Stanislaus winning by 10 points and Brendan probably getting his 250 and easily clearing that mark. We appreciate you watching again this weekend. We'll see you Friday night at the games.